upside down on third turn number four. Up into the cushion and grabbed it, over he went. Only 12 cars making it by the start finish line, but caution was called. Going back to the last fully completed lap again, only 12 cars able to make it by.
Just break that momentum. First off, I just want to let everyone know we're thinking about Jason Versley right now. He's a big part of our team. He's not here. He doesn't know he's watching. We love you, buddy. Keep working hard. That race is just special, man. Coming here and racing in this building. The crowd gets bigger and bigger every year. Thank you to my guys, Keekoons, Pete Willoughby, Kaz, Grady. Everybody does an unbelievable job on these race cars. They just, they show. They're winning three in a row this week so far. So my car just, as the race goes on, builds momentum. I could really just use that lateral grip in the right rear and just shoot me off the corner there at the end. My pace slowed down. I didn't want to make mistakes on the cushion. You buy so much time. It just, I knew I could sense Kevin behind me on the bottom, and I just was kind of waiting to make that last second move down there. I see him just off of turn two where I could get that extra little launch and clear him, and then just walk his run.
How'd you feel on that? Because I feel like kind of the heat race was just okay, not as dominant as I expected. Here comes Gus. Come on, Gus. There he is. Gus makes his way to victory lane. He's excited. But the heat race, just kind of good. Late in the qualifier, you really came to life. Is there something you guys found in that qualifier that you took to this AMA?
Yeah, we just worked on it. You know, you got a whole team effort. You got a lot of minds thinking alike and brainstorming things to be able to get our car better and better. That's what makes Keekoons Motorsports as an organization so great. And there's no egos in that room. So it's unbelievable to work with those guys. I cherish every moment I get to race with them. And I just, I'm happy I'm in a good spot for Saturday now.
Your seventh career prelim win. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank all you fans, man. This is an unbelievable place at Mahon and Lanny built. This is a special, special building to be able to race in.
Five straight Wednesday nights he's ended up here in victory lane. Let him hear you, Rico Andrew! We have Kevin Thomas Jr. up here and chat with KTJ. He gets a handshake from track chaplain Tim Spillman. And KTJ, you and I were talking there before Rico made his way to victory lane. How devastating was it to see him go to the bottom? And I know you sounded one and two. You thought, man, I can win this thing.
Yeah, rolling through one and two in the last lap was probably the best I got through it all race. And I felt like it was the closest I was to, maybe his left rear. But, he had a good head of steam going down the back stretch. And, it did the old Keith Coons hop, getting into three and stuck right there on the bottom. And, he won the race. So it's, hats off to those guys. They're 3-for-3 this week. That's a testament to what they do there at their shop. And, my guys did an awesome job. This is our first time in the car and being around and working with these guys. So, Randy Timms, Kiwi, Matt, Billy, everybody that works on that thing, they really gave me what I needed. So I'm proud to put that thing in the show for them, and now we go over to Lance.
Your best career prelim run with a team that's essentially brand new, just the last month or so. How good does it feel going into Saturday knowing that you felt this good in your prelim night and you're locked into the end?
It feels pretty good. That was a pretty technical racetrack right there, whether it be running the top or the bottom. So I know we got good speed and we felt good early too. So, we're 55 laps is going to be a long time on Saturday. So we're going to try to, get 25 more good laps out of it.
All right, Kevin Thomas Jr. comes home in second, and we'll get Blake Vaughn here. And Blake, man, this thing came to life in the race. I feel like a firewood.
Yeah, frustrating for sure. It really seems like last year just fell the exact same way. I was talking on Tyler Colby's goal for a second, rolling the bomb really well, and was able to, Courtney was able to see me on the jumbotron at the point down, and I think that's what happened tonight with KTJ. But, shout out to these guys. To be able to run third to Rico and KTJ is definitely good for us. So, we don't get to run this thing very much, so be able to come out here and be as fast as we are right out of that is definitely something to be proud of.
How tough is it to be so fast right out of the gates when you, as you just said, you don't get to run a midget a whole lot yet? 9-3-60 wins this year, but you didn't get to run the midget very much through 2021.
Yeah, really, I think this year helps me a ton. Just being able to get laps around this track, going to a smaller car, just trying to be consistent, just trying to focus on hitting my marks, and man, I try to roll the bottom. The top gets pretty treacherous around here, and I can get up there and go, but it's just a lot easier to roll the bottom, and it seems like it gets back towards the bottom towards the end of each year, right up there too.
Blake Hahn comes home in third. Your top two locked into the A-Main on Saturday. Kevin Thomas Jr., Enrico Abreu, and Brian Holbert, Randy Ward, Tony Bachhoven. Man, another spectacular feature inside this building.
Most definitely, we get ready to do it all again tomorrow. It's John Christer, Trucking Mall.